Hi, welcome to DevNet Create. Now I'm going to talk about the project SkyBridge. Before that, let me introduce about myself. I'm Rahul Prashant, Senior Network Consulting Engineer, working in Cisco for last 5 years, helping customers in their networking design and the proactive support in the various domains in enterprise networking, service providers, and SDN, software-defined networking, for SD-WAN and SDA. I'm an active speaker in various conferences like Data Symposium, Cisco Live, SECON, and NSO DevDays conferences. Automation innovation is always my passion, and that's a result of this project, right? We were doing manually, and we tried to automate that, and that's how the SkyBridge project came. So before going to the project, right? Why this project? What's the real problem we were facing before the SkyBridge comes? So consulting engineer like me, we used to solve a lot of customer problems daily. We see critical issues in the network, and finally it will be resulting in root causing into a bug, right? Some bug in a software. So we want to understand more details about that bug. We will go through the details about the bug in the email communications already happened between a consulting engineer like me and with a developer or engineering team of that bug, right? Who owns that bug. To understand more about this bug, we go through all these previous email communications which happened about this bug between our team and the bug developer team. So it takes a lot of time, right? A lot of hours we have to spend to understand about one issue. Then finally, we might get some answer out of it, or we might not get, right? So there's no one already discussed about this, the query which I have currently now. So then in that case, I write a new email to the developer, right, of that bug and ask my query. So I have to manually spend to go through all the existing email discussions, a lot of time. And at the end, if I didn't get answer, I have to write an email again. So this is a tedious process, right? So once we write the email, it will get archived. As I said, all the emails will be archived in the database. So this is an internal tool where we can go through all these email communications. So what has been already discussed, this is the UI of the tool. So as a consulting engineer, I have to go through all these email discussions, which takes a lot of time, okay? I didn't get any answer. So I will write a new email to a developer of the bug asking for more details. Then also there might no reply from the developer of the bug, right? He might be busy. He might not reply to me. Or even if he replied, it might be redirected to another DE. So the developer, he might redirect to someone in his team or some other team, right? Again, redirection happens in the email communication. So these are all the problems which the consulting engineer faces to understand about that issue. In other side, right, in other world, these are all the issues in my world. In other world, where a developer, he might be receiving same emails or same questions again and again by different consulting engineers from our team. So for a same bug or same issue, the same questions will be asked by first person, second person, and third person, right? Different emails. But it might be same questions asked repeatedly. So he might be also, right, worried, okay, too many emails with same questions. Why do I want to respond to all these emails, right? So from a developer engineering team perspective, they also will be very worried of spending times to respond to same queries to the consulting engineer team. So this is the real problem we have, the inter-department communication. So as a quick summary, we have the issue with an intuitive UI, right? As I showed the UI already here, it's really difficult to go through all the previous email communication because a lot of email headers, the signatures, right? Unwanted details you want to go through to find the answer. Redundancy, right? So repetitively same questions asked by us to the developers, right? Multiple emails for the same query. Right, unstructured data, as I told you, in the database, whatever we have, it's not structured. It's not easy to look into the what is the question, what is the answer previously discussed for the same issue. So I have to spend a lot of time go through this unstructured data, right? So no knowledge reuse. We are not using this data, right? In today's world, it's a data-driven world. We have all this data. We have to reuse it, right? Rather than keep on asking the same questions or keep on discussing the same things again and again. So sometimes, as I told, the unstructured data, information might get lost in headlines or signature, right? We think that it's a headline. We might not see the answer properly, right? So info gets lost in email headers, long HTML signatures, block of quoted text, right? This is just a single example of this UI, right, page. Similarly, a lot of hundreds of pages are there, right? Email discussions for a single issue. So we have to go through all those hundreds of pages to understand what that exact issue is. So this is the overall summary of the problem statement. How do we solve this problem, right? The interdepartment communication to understand about the issue. Here comes the SkyBridge to rescue over all the issues, right? So what the SkyBridge does, right? It bridges between our team, the consulting engineer team, and the developers, right? Engineering team. So as we discussed, right? We have the data in email communications archived. So searching through is difficult manually. Why can't we digitize that? Take all those archived data, all the email communications, clean those data, right? Remove the tags, remove the signature, remove the unwanted data, right? Then tag it with whatever data you want, digitize the data, right? Using NLP natural language processing, we use the modules. We digitize those data, clean it and tag it with a proper question and answer. We just take among all those email communications, we just take the what is the question asked, what is the answer replied by the developer, right? So our SkyBridge will be a platform, right, to give just a question and answers for the query which I have. So for example, currently I have one query and I just go to SkyBridge and ask, okay, for this issue, this bug, I have this query. So it searches through all the email communication. It searches for the query which I have. And if already the query has been asked, it will show up only that query, what is the answer to it. So because it has have a proper data, proper question and proper answer, right? Cleaned and tagged internally in database. So SkyBridge easily gives me whatever the question I have, it gives the question and answer already discussed based on my question. So how internally we store it in database, right? So we have all the email communications, right? Lot of discussions. We tag it, all the questions and answered together. So whichever question has an answer, we bucketize into one bucket, all the questions and answer. There might be some questions which is not unanswered, right? Which is not answered. So we bucketize into second bucket, the questions asked, but not answered. Unanswered questions, we will put in second bucket. Third bucket has no such questions asked, right? So I might be inputting one question to a SkyBridge, but that is not already asked at all. So my query input to the SkyBridge will fall under these categories. Either already asked, someone asked the question and we have an answer in a database, or already asked question, but no answer yet, or this is a new question I have, there is no answer at all. So it should fall under these three categories, right? Whenever I ask a question to a SkyBridge. So how do I internally store in DB, right? Whenever the question is asked like this, I understand, okay, so hi, XYZ, I don't know all those data. The content here is, does this bug impact this platform? Yes. So I just clean it, this data, and process it, and just keep the data, whatever I want, right? That digitized data and store it in DB, right? So I understood the question asked by the engineer. I have cleaned it up and take it up, and then I will store it in DB. Now I will search in DB for this question, right? Which is already asked, similar questions asked and answered. Then I will show it up. If not, if the question is asked but not answered, then I will note it down so that my SkyBridge platform automatically triggers an email to the developer team, right? To the other team. So these are all two cases. If no such question asked, again, a new mail will be triggered with the new question, which we imported to SkyBridge. So as a quick recap in this slide, so we have an email discussion archived in the database. We clean it and tag it with the proper question and answer alone by removing unwanted data and stored in DB. So whenever a consulting engineer wants to know about the already question and answer, he comes to SkyBridge, he just input his question. So it might be under these three category three bucket, which we already stored in database. So I get a question from consulting engineer, I remove it, I take only the critical data, right? The clean digitized data, the bug ID and the platform, whatever he's asking questions, right? Not the unwanted data. Then I will go into DB and I will search against this. So how do I search it? So I use TF-IDF vectorization, custom keyword vectorization as well to do the similarity check for the question asked with the database, with the DB I have, so that I retrieve the similar questions already asked, right? And if with the answer it is in that bucket, I will show both question and answer. If only question is there but not answer, then I will again trigger, I will take the analytics, I will analyze this question, then I will trigger an email. If it is a new question, then again I will trigger an email again. So let's see that in more detail. See, like me, consulting engineer queries for a bug related information. Okay, so it searches in a bucket one in a database, whether the most similarly question and answers, right? Already asked question with the answer in that bucket, it will search. So how it will search? As I told, TF-IDF vectorization and custom keyword weighted vectorization is the model or a logic in the backend we're using. So it searches, and if it is present, yes, it outputs the recommended question and answers. Based on my question, if it's there, then it will recommend the questions with the answers to me. No, if it is not there in this bucket, right, answered bucket, then it goes to the unanswered bucket, not answered by DE yet. Yeah, the question might be asked already, right, but not answered. Then if that's the case, again, I use the same to match the similar question, right? I use the same logic, TF-IDF vectorization, custom keyword weighted vectorization. Then present, yes. Then I will do the counter plus plus analytics. So why do this analytics? The question is not answered by the team, developer team, but the same question still the consulting engineer has, right? So I understand this question is really critical for this issue. They want the answer. So I do the analytics. I understand, okay, this is a really critical question to be answered. So we will, this platform SkyBridge will trigger an email again to a developer team to get answered as soon as possible. And again, once it got answered, it will again store it in DB. So that our consulting engineer again asks this question, he will get an answer. So that's the analytics part which we're showing up here. So we'll quickly go through the snapshots, right, of this tool, how before SkyBridge, how we do manually, and after SkyBridge, with the help of SkyBridge, how we can do it now currently. So before SkyBridge, right, we have this internal tool where we put our, say, bug ID example, one issue, put a bug ID, we will have a lot of mail threads or communications in each of these links. So I click on a particular link, this link, this is the UI which opens up in the particular single link. So I have to scroll down this link and then I have to see the questions answered, right? What is the question asked by other consulting engineer like me? What is the answer replied back? So this is a single email communication. Similarly, there will be hundreds of email communications in each link. So I have to click on each of these links, I have to go through these emails manually and understand what the exact the answer given by the DE, right? If the question is already asked, but if I have a question, if it's not already asked, then this manual, whatever I read through, it's no use, right? Because I have a question which is not already discussed in the email chains, right? Which already had a communications. So now it's even going through all these hundreds of pages, no use for me because this question is not already asked. So now our SkyBridge comes. After SkyBridge, now it's very simple. Go and put your bug ID, right? We have already digitized the data, whatever we have in our database. It's a proper question and just an answer. And when, even the timestamp, right? When it was discussed. So this is the question, right? Whether this platform impacting this release. And yeah, I believe all these line cards doesn't apply. It won't impact, right? Just a few seconds, you read through it. You can understand what is the question asked? What is the answer? Rather than going through all those hundreds of pages and resulting in, right, it might not be there. So here in the Sky Bridge, if question and answer is not relevant to you, right, it automatically understand it triggers an email based on the question you give. So I have given just a bucket here. You can even type a complete question here, right? So this whether this bug impact ASR9K platform. So you can type complete question. It understand what the question is. If that question is not asked, it won't give any question and answer here. So because whatever the question you ask, it match up with the database. Similar question only it will show up. Now it just I gave Bugatti, all the question and answers are showing up. But if I give a question, it will just show up a similar question. And if there is no similar question, it automatically emails in the backend and it will show a pop-up here saying the email has been sent to the developer and this question has no answer till now. It will show up to you so that you know that, okay, there is no answer till now and email has been already triggered. Now you can go on to your next task or next work and you can do it. You don't need to wait or you don't need to email separately manually. So that's the advantage of the Sky Bridge, which manually saves your time rather than going through all these already asked question and answers. And also, if it's a new question, it understand itself, okay, the question is not already asked. It will show you that, okay, this is not already asked. We have triggered an email to the team, developer team. So what's the advantage, right? Final quick summary, what's the business outcome, right? We are not consulting engineer time is not wasted to going through the email archived communications, right? As the developer team, right, from an engineering team, the time is not wasted to answer the repetitive similar emails, right? Rather than answering the same answers to the multiple persons for the same query, right? So they can also increase their productivity, right? Not wasting the time on replying to the same questions. So this result in decreasing the turnaround time and better analytics. So turnaround time to customer, right? As a consulting engineer for me, I'm analyzing an issue or a bug, right? So I get in a few seconds, I get the answer out of it, right? So I can immediately say to my customer, okay, this is the details about this issue or about this bug. So I'm decreasing my turnaround time internally and I'm giving more value to my customer, right? Obviously the OpEx savings from my side, consulting engineer, or even from a developer side. Overall, we are improving a customer experience here. So we are saving our consulting engineer time and also developers time, which resulting in OpEx savings. Finally, resulting in turnaround time to giving back the answers to our customers. So which is resulting in improving the customer experience. So it's a win-win for everyone. Thank you.